Let's talk about line graph. On there are two axes. On x-axis we have taken the production of rice in million tons, and on y-axis we have taken the number of years, right? And the production is in 10 million tons, 20 with a difference or interval of 10 million tons each, and on the other hand years, in case of years it is 80, then 82 and 84, there is a difference of 2 years in between each segment, right? Let's say if it is 80, it is 82, so in between it is going to be 81. Let's, for those people who doesn't know how to read a line graph, let's draw a line basically, right, like this. So if we wish to see the production in the year 1980, what we are supposed to do is that we are simply to join this line 1980. Wherever it crosses over here, we have to join this on the production side. And if it is, since meeting over here, and if it is 10, this is 20, it is somewhere in between. So it is going to be the 15 million ton production in the year 1980. Similarly, if you wish to know the production in the year 1982, so it basically crosses over here. And once we, let's say, meet, it comes over here, which is approximately or around 17 million tons. So this is the production in 82, and if you wish to know in between 81, then again you have to join this line like this, and then this, it is going to be around 16 million ton. So this is how we come to know about the production. Simply you join the lines and wherever it crosses, you join to this side. So this point is going to be the exact production in that particular year. So let's mark it, the point A, the starting point, and then this year as, let's say, the B point. This is for simply A, to make you understand about the different facts, what is happening in this particular segment. So in this particular segment from A to B, you see that it is initially 15, then after 1 year it is around 16 or something, 16 plus, then in the year 82 it is around 17, and if you wish to know about in the year 86, let's say, so in the year 86 it is going to be somewhere around, let's say, 20 or 21, it's 20, let's say in the year 86 it is going to be 20 million tons of production. So you see the production in increasing by 1 million ton in or 1.5 million ton, and again 1 million ton every year. So this kind of growth, generally we call it as a gradual growth, or slow or steady, right? And the growth or increase, we can interpret it with the words increase, rise, grow, swell, with the phrases like shot up, went up, jumped up. So here you can see, so in this particular scenario, in between A and B, the production is rising slowly or gradually, right? Then after that, if we see from B to C, if it is like this, a sort of straight line from B to C. So in this particular case, if you see at point B, it is around 20. At point, let's say in the year 88, it is again going to be 20. Then if we see in the year 90, it is again going to be 20. So this kind of production, since there is no change, we call it as a, so from point B to C, you can take it as the production is constant or same or similar or stagnant. We can use a number of different words for this kind of situation. Yes, we can use a phrase also, no change. It can be defined as after 1986 there was no change in production, right? And or you, otherwise you can say the production remained constant in between 86 to 90. Let's say, what is the next situation? In the next situation, we are presuming that the production is increasing like this. So, and it's good, it is increasing like this. So this is a sort of rapid incline in production. So for this, from C to D, let's say it stops over here. So what we can say is that from C to D, the kind of change which is happening, that can be like this, rapid increase or steep increase और शार्प इंक्लाइन और सिग्निफिकेंट ग्रोथ और नोटिसिएबली स्वेल और एक्सपोनेंशियल राइज मार्क्ड इंक्रीज. सो दीज आर द वर्ड्स विच वी कैन यूज और यू कैन यूज फॉर टेलिंग दिस काइंड ऑफ प्रोडक्शन प्रोडक्शन और चेंज विच इज हैपनिंग इन बिटवीन सी टू डी सेक्शन ऑफ द ग्राफ. एंड ऑफ कोर्स लेट्स से इफ द ग्राफ मूव्स लाइक दिस लेटर ऑन, सो दिस पॉइंट इज गोइंग टू बी द हाइएस्ट लेवल ऑफ प्रोडक्शन. सो डी पॉइंट इज डेफिनेटली गोइंग टू बी द हाइएस्ट लेवल ऑफ प्रोडक्शन और द मैक्सिमम लेवल ऑफ प्रोडक्शन और द पीक लेवल ऑफ प्रोडक्शन, राइट. सो आफ्टर डी इफ यू कैन सी इट्स वेरी क्लियरली सीन दैट आफ्टर डी वॉट इज हैपनिंग आफ्टर डी यू आर सेइंग इट इज नाउ गोइंग डाउन. एंड लेट्स से दिस इज द ई पॉइंट टिल दिस इट गोज डाउन. नाउ द प्रोडक्शन इन इंक्रीजिंग. लेट्स से इन द ईयर दिस हाइएस्ट लेवल इज इन द ईयर यू अटेन इन द ईयर 1996 एंड आफ्टर 1996 नाउ इट इज स्टार्टिंग इट हैज स्टार्टेड गोइंग डाउन. देन टिल फॉर एग्जाम्पल लेट्स से फॉर द ईयर्स फॉर नेक्स्ट टू फोर सिक्स फॉर द नेक्स्ट 6 years इट हैज गोन डाउन. And this kind of now this is decline and it can be shown with the same words like gradual, slow and steady, right. So now instead of incline, since it is decline, we can use the words like decrease, we can use the word decline, we can use the word plunge for this. Yes, reduce, fell down, went down. So these are the different kind of words which can be used for this kind of a change in the line graph. Right, and let's say we move ahead to the next point. Like after, let's say we presume that it fall or falls like this. So this is a sort of again fall, which is you can say very steep in nature. So if we say now this is and it stops over here. So if it is E to F, if we wish to say and E to F, we are seeing what is happening. It has fallen down very sharply. So we can use the words which we used over here, but here it was an incline, but now this is a decline. So we will use almost the same words: steep, sharp, significantly, noticeably, right. So these kind of words can be used to denote these kind of decline. And of course, the words other we can use decline, decrease, plunge, fell down. Or one more phrase which we can use for this kind of fall is fell drastically. That in between this 2002 and let's say this is the period 2006 or little bit less than 6 or let's say 2006. So within these 4 years it fell down sharply, right? So then in next scenario if you see then F to G what is happening and G to H what is happening. From F to G there is we can denote is by for F to G there is a minor or slight increase. And if we say for G to F what is happening, there is minor or slight dip, that there is a minor increase followed by a minor dip, right. So this is what is the body and how we can explain the body and what kind of different changes which can happen in the body, right. For example, initially you saw there was a steady incline. We used the word steady, gradual and slow. After that it remained constant. Then there was a steep or sharp incline. Then again there was a gradual fall. Then a significant decline. Then a minor increase and a minor decline. Now